गुड इवनिंग आवर स्पेशल गेस्ट डायरेक्टर पंजाबी बाग सेंटर, डायरेक्टर कालूसराय सेंटर, डायरेक्टर द्वारका सेंटर, रिस्पेक्टेड फैकल्टी मेंबर्स, पेरेंट्स एंड डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई मनीषा पठानिया ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ नारायणा ग्रुप विश यू एंड योर फैमिली अ वेरी गुड हेल्थ. टूडे ऑन 2nd August 2020 वी ऑल आर गैदर्ड हियर ऑन अ कॉमन प्लेटफॉर्म टू अटेंड अ वेबिनार. द टॉपिक फॉर डिस्कशन हियर टूडे इज how easy it is to crack JEE Advanced Entrance Exam. Today, I take the honor and privilege to welcome our honorable and distinguished guest, Director Punjabi Bagh Center, Mr. Anurag Mishra, an IITian from Roorkee, himself coaching for physics for nearly 3 decades. Director Dwarka Center, Mr. Pavan Khandelwal, BE Electrical, coaching mathematics for nearly 2 decades. Director Kalusrai Center, Mr. Sanjeev, BE coaching chemistry for nearly 2 decades. All our distinguished directors and faculties are behind the success for all our top rankers and students who have qualified the IIT JEE exam. Before we start our webinar, it gives me an immense and great pleasure to share with you about this empire. The foundation of Narayana Group was laid in 1979 by our Honorable Chairman, Dr. P. Narayana, serving as the best platform for national and state level entrance exams. Today, marked as Asia's one of the best coaching centers, catering to nearly 4 lakh students across India, the organization celebrates its success with 40,000 employees, 300 plus schools, 300 plus junior colleges in 13 states with 41 years of excellence and nearly 8 professional colleges. The success man behind our entire empire is our Honorable Chairperson, Dr. P. Narayana. As an educationalist, he always believed the absolute completion of a student's education happens only after we have bestowed our services towards their overall development, in addition to endowing them with career-oriented training and knowledge. Even during COVID-19 crisis, learning continued at Narayana. We were the first in the country to successfully run online classes from 25th March 2020, just when the lockdown was declared. It was welcomed not only by our regular classroom program students, but also 3,000 students from other institutes enrolled with us in our crash course program for IIT and NEET students. Narayana maintained the legacy of producing top ranks year after year. And this trend continued this year also. Thus, undisrupted quality teaching has become an inherited feature of our academic system. This has already been proven through our unmatched results year after year, where in Narayana has produced minimum 2 ranks in top 10 for consecutive 10 years. This was only possible under the guidance of our chairman, Dr. P. Narayana, along with his renowned faculty members. This is now my sincere request to Director Dwarka, Mr. Pavan Khandelwal, to please guide us with the valuable thoughts as how to crack JEE Advanced in an easy way. Pavan sir is also taking care of our end digital app. A little bit features of our end digital app, which I like parents and students to know. Our end digital app has been for having the following features. It has recordings for live classes available now. Real scenario test series with an absolute timer feature. Question paper with response sheet immediately after the test submitted. Assignments with detailed solutions and video explanations. Practice questions subtopic wise, analysis of your test performance. This is the best e-learning experience with Narayana. I would now request Pavan sir to take over and please guide us with his valuable thoughts. Over to Pavan sir.
Thanks, ma'am. Good evening to all dear parents, students. In this pandemic situation, first of all, I wish for each and everyone be safe, and I hope all of you are fine, and particularly the students who are stuck into the last session due to this COVID situation. At this juncture, on the behalf of Narayana, we all come together here just to give more clarity about the particularly advanced and some bits of JE mains also. I will request to ma'am, please share the analysis also that we have been prepared for the students, if it is possible. Otherwise, I will continue with that only. So first of all, the round number one, that means JE mains, has been completed, and all the aspirants are waiting for the JE advance and for the JE mains. Here I am not going to talking too much about the JE mains, because if I discuss about the JE mains, it is already the past event, it has been gone, and you have already taken the experience in live already, what you have faced, which type of question came, which type of error you have committed, and particularly wherever you have done the error. I think wherever you are studying, if I talk about the Narayana system, we have done the work particularly on those areas with the students where they have done the mistakes. This is our USP, I can say. Just on the behalf of Narayana group, first of all, I would like to introduce myself. I am the digital head of the Narayana division, and we are working in this particular situation with the digital mode. Seamlessly, we are conducting our online classes across the India. Not only in North and South, I am talking about North India, South India, means it is a complete across India we are working, and we are doing in this such a way so that our student may get advantage and they not suffer due to any problem in this COVID situation. Wherever required, we have sent the assignment. Wherever required, we give the video solution. Particularly, our USP is our test assessment, and it is going on continuously. It is our on and learn app. So, first of all, I would like to request to ma'am, if it is possible, please share the slides, and otherwise give me the share screen. I will start on my system. Okay, anyway, if possible, ma'am, you share it. Otherwise, I'm going to continue. So in the first round, means almost the first round, means JE mains has been completed. And after this, I am thinking to deliver the things about the JE advance particularly. And for that, you required clarity about the JE advance 2019. In each and every year, the Narayana is increasing their expertization, and it is not nothing new for us, because we are doing this since 2007 or 8, as ma'am stated earlier. Since last 12 years consecutively, we are giving at least 2 ranks in top 10 and numerous follow-up ranks also. In JE Advance, particularly the myths about the JE Advance in the student, in the surrounding, as when I enter into the class, in general, I heard the one statement, sir, JE Advance is very, very hard. I can't do it. It is not for me. I cannot solve the JE Advance paper. And when I entered into the JE Advance examination hall, I shivered at that time. So some suggestions, advice here, and our panel is here. Anurag sir is expert in physics, Sanjeev sir an expert in chemistry, I am myself in mathematics. We have analyzed, and we are doing since last 15 years we are serving here, and we have seen different types of papers. If I go through by the year by year, in general, the little bit maths paper, the trend is little bit high, but it is not always true. Sometimes the physics may be tough, sometimes chemistry or maths, it depends year to year. But yes, if you talk about the JE Advance 2019, the maths paper was really tough. But whenever the paper is tough, certainly cutoff will be the low. So particularly in this exam, the strategy matters how you have attempted the paper at that particular time. You should not feel the pressure. You should accept the situation. You should follow the paper particularly, first of all, where is the easy level, which type of questions you have gone through in the last 2 years or 3 years, wherever you have studied. And after that, you must start your paper. If the slide sharing is there, so certainly I will show some analysis also. So by this, you can understand how much means there are so many parameters by which you can understand the paper. First of all, the 11th and 12th distribution of marks was there, means how much contribution of the class 11th in JEE Advanced and how much contribution of the class 12th syllabus. If I talk in general, so you can say the 40% syllabus come from the class 11th and 60% approx it will come from the class 12th.
Also, go ahead and share your screen.
I hope it is visible for each and everyone now.
Yes.
Yes, Pavan sir.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Kapas. This is the some brief discussion about the JEE Advanced. Here I am sharing the little bit analysis in terms of only particularly advanced JEE Advanced 2019, and after that we will come over the JEE Mains. As far as last year concerned, approx 33,000 total number of qualified boys and 5,300 approximate 5,000 girls has been qualified JEE Advanced out of 2,24,000. The first figure I would like to bring in your knowledge, 2,24,000 students have been qualified to write the JEE Advanced examination. And right now we have 23 IITs. I hope each and everyone has aware about it. And approximate 11,983 seats with us right now in India. So total number of that particular figure means the common rank list has been released for 33,000 approximate for boys, and the different categories are here. Approximate, the branch wise, the category wise is there, 7,000 approx for the OBC, 8,000 approximate for SC candidates, and 3,000 vice versa. This is the different category. This is the obviously the post analysis. At this juncture, first particularly, this is the high time to discuss about the JEE Advanced strategy. So this is the last year cutoff analysis. The common rank list means the last student who got the rank from the JEE department, IIT department, it was the minimum percentage was 25% for the general and 22.5 for EWS category, and for OBC same as 22.5. After that, you can see almost it is uniform 12.5 till up to ST PWD. And the preparatory course, it is approx 6.25. So first of all, we should focus on this 25.0. How we can achieve it? Because 100% paper is not for anyone. Even topper cannot attempt the 100%. Sometimes the rank one got 85%, even maybe 80%. And I think last 2 years, 2010 and 2016, approximate 85% students got the rank one. And in each and every year that I will show into the slide also, above 90%, there are one or two students out of the 10 candidates who are getting the rank number one or rank number two. So anyway, if I talk about in generalized manner, first of all, I would like to keep your focus on this 25.0. How you can achieve it, because today is 2nd August and the 27th September is the date for the JEE Advance. Because I hope you each and every one has been prepared very well for the JEE mains. And I hope you should not have any doubt in this regard of this JEE mains. You can do advanced preparation from the today itself means, today itself means you have done already. This is the time of consolidation, means you have to start your preparation in such a way so that this minimum marks you can secure with your good strategy. For that, I will share some subject wise analysis in front of you. First of all, I would like to request to Sanjeev sir, please share some glimpse of the chemistry so that the student can understand how they can score good and at this time what they should do so that they can become pressure free and they can do very well in the chemistry examination at the time of JEE Advance. Sanjeev sir, I will request to you.
Bhavan sir, good evening to dear participants and my learned friends. Bhavan sir has already discussed a lot of pros and cons regarding the preparation aspect and rest of the things. And I was also going through the Q&A section. There was a question from Mule Rajshekhar Reddy. Is JEE hard? I fully subscribe the idea of Bhavan sir. It is not, in fact, a difficult examination. Of course, it's a different examination. For those who are in the safe hand, who are under the competent guidance, and they have some strategy to excel through it. As Pawan sir has shared the screen, last previous screen is about 25 to 30% marks is good enough to get through JEE Advance. And throughout your academic career of 14 years, none of you have ever scared about getting the 35% marks in your school life. So how can it be a difficult thing? Now let us talk about chemistry. The first thing you should know about chemistry is chemistry is going to fetch you in two different ways. The first one, it is going to give you marks. And the second one is none of the subject can fetch you is time. Time in the examination hall. Compared to rest of the two subjects, physics and mathematics, chemistry can give you more marks in slightly lesser time and lesser point of level. And second thing, you can solve the chemistry paper in comparatively lesser time and you can save around 15 to 20 minutes of the examination hall, which you can utilize anywhere else in physics and mathematics because you can understand the nature of chemistry. In chemistry, as all of you are aware, there are three different facets of chemistry, physical, organic, and inorganic. At least you will get 50% of the questions, which can be done merely by seeing the question. No need of even taking a page or any calculation or any other sort of thing. So this will save your time. This thing will never happen in mathematics and hardly will happen in physics. So that way, chemistry is a different thing. It will fetch you time also. Another important aspect about which I want to draw your attention. Quite often, you discriminate between physical, organic, and inorganic. Never do that. Physical is a tool meant to understand so that you can apply very well in organic and inorganic. Quite a good number of students can correlate physical chemistry with organic also, and they deal the organic situation very well with the help of the concept they have learned in physical chemistry. But of course, hardly I have throughout in my career of last 20 years of teaching for JEE, I found very less number of students who really correlate the physical chemistry in inorganic chemistry. They have a simple idea. They understand it very well that physical chemistry is something like physics. So any mind which is analytical mind indeed he is equally comfortable with physical chemistry as he is with physical or physics or mathematics. Organic, slightly different thing. It requires the practice like mathematics. So you just keep on doing more and more number of questions if you have sound revision of the basics in organic chemistry. Now, I would like to discuss about inorganic chemistry, which is normally discussed very less. You can understand, if you are preparing for chemistry and you are not taking care of inorganic chemistry so rigorously, that means you are ready to give the walkover. Because under any circumstance, even the slide is there. If you go through the slide, you will find inorganic chemistry will take at least 25 to 30% marks. Out of 25, even if I go to the conservative side, out of 25% marks, you can score at least 20% marks very, very easily if you go strategically. Many of us, of the students are of the opinion that inorganic chemistry is something which can be learned by cramming or which can be just memorized. This is not the fact. Your strategy should be clear. Don't go so much exhaustive for the entire syllabus. Rather, you have to have in-depth idea about the application power of the physical chemistry whichever has been taught to you in the physical section. Such as for hydrolysis, there was a topic in hydrolysis in ionic equilibrium. Normally, a student consider this one is meant to deal with the questions for physical chemistry, whereas none of the year is there wherein the JEE Advanced don't put any question from the hydrolysis aspect. The ratio of charge upon size, which is a quite important factor to deal with the hydrolysis situation, quite often they keep on giving the questions from there. Similarly, there are many aspects of thermal instability, which is being basically influenced by the size and ratio of the ions, that could be very well correlated with the concept of physical chemistry. In fact, there is a section called general chemistry, like oxidation reduction, some part of the chemical bonding, concept of acid and base. These are a few things which can be considered very deeply to understand the inorganic aspect. And furthermore, there is a chapter called coordination compound. That chapter alone can fetch you more than 5% marks. For a paper, for a student who is in fact struggling to get 30% marks, if there is a single chapter and quite easy chapter which can fetch you 5 to 8% marks. So your focus should be there also, not to lose any marks in the inorganic chemistry. And lastly, I would advise you to go through the practical manual of chemistry meant to you to deal with the lab work in 10 plus 2. Because there are two very important sections given over there, which is inorganic qualitative analysis. You won't find any such chapter in your normal NCERT textbook of 11 and 12. It is there in the practical manual. That should be considered very well for the to score the marks, because there are a lot of questions which comes from there, as well as there is a section practical organic chemistry that is once again not given in such a detail in normal textbook, that is there in practical practical book. So that very book also considered by you, so that you can score there very well. Now let us have this slide section. If you will go through it and you will analyze the entire situation, then you can understand getting 25 or 30% marks is not at all a difficult aspect. I have named you some of the chapters which are quite important. But one more thing I would like to add. Don't treat inorganic chemistry as a separate thing. Rather, you try to incorporate the concept you learned in the physical chemistry to understand it. Particularly in advanced level question, there are a lot of basic concepts hidden in that. There is nothing which can be done merely by remembering the concept. That are not factual questions. It appears factual to you because you don't apply the concept. It is in the same way what a person who is very more organic chemistry, he applies the actual concept in each and every question. But for the normal person, every question seems as if it is a new reaction. It goes like that. And lastly, winning of war is in fact important, not every matter. So even in the chemistry paper, you will find there are around 50 to 60% questions which are of moderate level or easy level. Just go upon that question in the paper first, and then you would be able to get some of the time, you will be able to extract some of the time for the rest of the section also. And apart from this, whatever I have stated earlier, organic needs practice, physical needs concept, inorganic, quite in-depth idea of application. So I think these are good enough for you. If you go in that way, then surely it will help you out. Now, Pawan sir will again take you to the journey further.
Thank you, Sanjeev sir, for the good advice. Because the students are struggling at this time and they are not able to know what they do because they are doing so many things, but they are not understanding what is exactly they have to do at this time so that they can reach their optimum level. Okay, thank you, Sanjeev sir. Now I will request Anurag sir, please share some tips for the physics to our students so that they will become comfortable in the physics also. Over to Anurag sir.
Thank you, Pawan sir. Good evening, all of you. As far as physics is concerned, it is in between, you can say, maths and chemistry. Chemistry is a bit, more scoring, maths becomes a bit more tougher, but physics sometimes becomes tough or easy. If you have prepared strategically, then the people will find the paper tough. The point is, if we see the physics, we can divide the total physics in 11 segments. 11th class, we can divide it in 4 segments. Mechanics, which covers kinematics, laws of motion, work power energy, center of mass conservation, momentum rotation, and gravitation. Second segment, fluids properties of matter. This mechanics part constitutes 20 to 25% of the paper. Fluid plus properties of matter constitutes nearly 8 to 10%. Third segment is SHM plus sound wave, which again constitutes nearly 8 to 10% to 12% also. Heat and thermodynamics constitutes nearly 10 to 15%. Electromagnetism, now 12th class, we have only 3 segments. Electromagnetism, geometrical and wave optics, and modern physics. Electromagnetism constitutes nearly 30 to 35%. Geometrical and wave optics nearly 10 to 12%. And modern physics also 10 to 12%. Point is, if any student scores 60% marks aggregate, he will get a rank in top 1000. That means, if you score 60% marks, you are among the top 1000 student of 12 lakh students who are appearing in this exam. So first of all, I will tell you the strategy, how to get into the 60% slab. Normally, kya hota hai? Student thinks that those who know mechanics, they only know physics. And they struggle for 2 years in laws of motion, work power energy, conservation of momentum, rotation, and all those things. And finally, in the exam, they are not able to attempt those questions. Most of the students, mediocre students, are not able to attempt, except the extraordinary students. So my advice is, there are few segments which are 100% scoring. Heat and thermodynamics, you can go through all the 30-year questions, you can go any book, you will find that the question concepts are normally 90% repeated. So heat and thermodynamics, if you are preparing, that means 15%, 12 to 15% question paper constitutes from heat and thermodynamics. So 10 to 15% paper is easy, that is heat and thermodynamics. 10 to 15% modern physics, that is again easy, atomic physics and nuclear physics. Geometrical and wave optics, again, 10 to 15%. That means even if you take these three segments, heat and thermodynamics, modern physics, and geometrical and wave optics, you will score 30 to 35%. That is the cutoff range which will fetch you a rank in top 10,000 or 12,000 rank. Now, after seeing this thing, fluid, SHM sound wave. SHM sound wave, again, if you go, that is constituting nearly 10% marks. Fluids and electromagnetism, that is electricity, electrostatics, current electricity, magnetism, EMI, AC, that constitutes nearly 30 to 35%. Even if you are able to attempt from mechanics 10% questions or 20% questions, and from electromagnetism nearly 50% questions, and in other segments, you are able to complete nearly 80%. That means if there is a question of 15 marks in heat and thermodynamics, and you are making correct 12 marks, so your score will be nearly 60 to 65 marks. And you will be among top 1,000 student scorer as far as physics is concerned. As far as the toppers is concerned, those who are expecting a rank in top 10 or top 100, they are going to crack all the portions. So I'm not discussing about them. They have to be selective. But what I want to tell is, advanced exam is to optimize your performance. I'm repeating, it is to optimize your performance. It is not to maximize your performance. Students who want to maximize their performance, they are trapped in negative marking, and their performance, net performance, goes down. Also, top rankers, if we leave the top rankers, then the other students have some weak portions and some strong portions. So what is my advice during this 1.5 months while you are revising the topics? First of all, revise all the topics, but don't give more importance to those topics in which you are weak and you are thinking that I will improve it in these 1.5 months. Because if you are strengthening your strong portion, and the strong portion constitutes 60 to 70%, then even if the weak portion you have revised thoroughly, that if some easy question comes in that segment you are able to attempt, then you are able to solve the paper 65 to 70%, you are in top 500. So my point is, in life also, we always crave for the thing which we do not have. We are never satisfied with what we do have. Similarly, in our preparation also, we are not satisfied with what we know. We are always dissatisfied with what we don't know. When we are going to attempt in the paper, we get, I am not confident with the fluids. When I go into the paper, I turn the paper and find that, this is a figure of fluids. Then I will immediately get whether the question is easy or tough, but my BP will increase, that question of fluid has come. Similarly, this total exam of IIT Advanced, the biggest part is not the subject knowledge. The biggest part is you have to fight and overcome your psychological barrier. The psychological pressure which this creates, that I am giving IIT Advanced, it will be a tough exam. I will crack a joke here. Joke is of Dara Singh. Dara Singh was number one wrestler at one point of time in the whole world. So one thief who was very strong entered in Dara Singh's house. He was not knowing that it is Dara Singh's house. He took the valuables and he was running back. Dara Singh got up and he tried to overcome the thief. But thief was even stronger, and he just throw away the Dara Singh. Then Dara Singh started shouting. Dara Singh himself started shouting, "Dara Singh, please come, some thief has come. Dara Singh, please come, some thief has come." Then the thief thought that I have entered the house of Dara Singh. He threw away all the valuables and ran away. That means the thief was able to overcome Dara Singh, but he was not able to overcome the name of Dara Singh, the fame of Dara Singh. That is with the IIT. If that few questions of IIT are asked in JEE Mains or in your coaching exams, you will be able to crack them. But if they are asked in IIT, then you think that because it is in IIT, something special, it requires some special treatment. Once in 2004, one question came where side of the cube was given, and question was to find out the volume of the cube. Some students came out after the exam, they said, "Sir, this is IIT question. They have asked the volume of a cube," when actually it was the question of significant figures. But the point is, many students didn't attempt it. They thought that something is required in this question, which I am not knowing. Because IIT cannot ask simple question of asking volume of a cube. It is a class 8 question when the dimensions are given. So my point is, when you are preparing, first of all, revise all topics, prepare a revision schedule according to your strength and weightage of topics in advance. For weak topics, just revise to the point that if something easy comes in that portion, you are not able to, you are able to do and you are not leaving them. Go through your notes, whatever coaching you have done, wherever you have studied, just revise all the things in these 1.5 months. Because what you have gained in 1.5 years, 2 years, that must come within these 1.5 months in front of you. Solve last 30 years IIT papers. Don't be panicked that I am not knowing the mechanics or something. Just, I told you, heat and thermodynamics, sound and wave, modern physics, geometrical and wave optics. These 40% questions to 45% questions are easy to score in the physics portion. So don't fight with those questions which you find difficult for yourself. And as far as the 11th and 12th weightage is concerned, the weightage of 12th class is nearly 55% in physics, and the weightage of 11th class is around 45%. So 12th class topics, that is electromagnetism, geometrical and wave optics, and modern physics, constitutes a more weightage as for contribution as far as ITJ is concerned. So you should totally focus on that thing. And the physics paper requires your analytical and comprehension ability. Try to analyze the question. They will not be direct formula based. You have to comprehend the passage. In passage, you have to think what the examiner is asking, and go through the questions thoroughly. Second thing, what one more advice is there. There are different types of questions in advance. Single correct choice, more than one correct choice, comprehension type, matrix match type, integer type. My advice is attempt the more than one correct choice at the end, because if four options are correct in that more than one correct choice, that question is equivalent to four single correct choice questions. And if the negative marking is there, you will be trapped there. So your first point is you have to solve those questions which are easy, which you can score comfortably. So single correct choice, comprehension, and integer type questions should be attempted first. Then more than one correct choice and matrix match. They should be attempted at the end, because there you will require more time and chances of committing mistake is more. Second thing, how much time you should give to the physics paper. In 3-hour paper, physics requires actually 1 1-hour for each, but normally physics is chemistry students used to complete by 40-45 minutes. So they save 15 to 20 minutes from chemistry, and that is required for maths or physics. Normally maths always requires 1 hour 10 minutes to 1 hour 15 minutes. So physics, you will get physics time for physics 1 hour and 1 hour 5 minutes. So you have to solve the physics paper within 1 hour to 1 hour 5 minutes, or at the most 1 hour 10 minutes. So go with the strategy. Physics is not tough. Strategically take the segments and you can 100% score better than what you are scoring today. You will 100% improve on that part. So your performance is good. You will improve. And if it goes to 70-75%, your chances in coming top 100 is also favorable then. Now, Pawan sir, you can take over.
Thank you, Anurag sir. So this was the analysis of the chemistry and physics has been done. Now I would like to share some glimpse of mathematics part also. As I studied earlier, there are two types of division in JEE Advanced paper. In fact, in JEE Advanced, we cannot say the question is exclusively based on a single concept. The problem will be a multi-concept. The question may be of complex with coordinate. The question may be with the complex with trigonometry, and different types of mixing concept may be there. So first of all, I would like to tell with all the students, read the question carefully and gather your information in your mind, what you know, try to accumulate at one place, and then you start the problem. Because that is not the time to do experiment. Whenever you are in examination hall, at that time you must attempt the question paper with your strength. Don't start with the experiment. Don't do the experiment in the meanwhile time. So this is obviously, you have listened so many times. All of us, we are here just you put the focus on some basic things, means this is the some last few days, what we can do best, what is the way to come with the optimum level. So here I would like to share some slide regarding to mathematics. There are three or four major portions. Fifth one is the miscellaneous. One part is algebra. Algebra divided into two parts in the class 11th and as well as in the class 12th. Coordinate is completely from the class 11th. Five questions came from the coordinate in JEE Advanced 2019. This is not just like means I am not sharing the number. This number matters a lot for you. If you want to get really to enter into the IIT, then definitely this number will be the miraculous for you. This statistics will be very, very helpful because this comes out after a very good research and with the discussion. In algebra, there are some one or two questions. One is means algebra means complex number. Just I'm covering here. Some more chapter will come into the next slide. In coordinate geometry, that covers straight lines, circle, parabola, ellipse, hyperbola. I will not say the whole question will come from the straight line only, or question may come from the circle directly. The question may be of such type, the question will start from the circle and then it will mix with the ellipse. So 100% exclusively called circle and ellipse, I would like to prefer here rather than telling in this way, two question from a straight line or one question from circle or ellipse hyperbola. Here I would like to say the five questions on the coordinate geometry, five questions on the differential calculus. Calculus that has the major component in the JEE Advanced examination as well as in JEE Mains also, because one attempt is still there left. So you must think about the calculus in very, very sincere manner, because this is the bread and butter for you. And by using the calculus and algebra itself, you can get 50 to 60% marks in the examination. In differential calculus, the five questions are coming in general. This is the last year, but in general, it is coming two questions on the function, two questions from the application of derivatives. As all of you know very well, the application of derivative has the multi-concept chapter. The question will be a multi-concept. Another part of the calculus is integral calculus. So if I take altogether five questions from the differential calculus, six questions from the integral calculus, that makes total number of questions 11. And I think it is a major component. After this, matrix and determinant, this is the one of the bonus portion. This is one of the portion by which the student can fetch the score very, very easy, because matrix and determinant, this is the class 12th chapter. And in terms of complexity, it is really a good chapter. It is a really easy chapter. If you have gone through by the CBSE part particularly, then 100% by using some more property, by using some or add some properties, you can solve this question until unless it doesn't fall into the very, very tough category. Next is permutation and combination. It is the exclusive chapter, as all of you know very well. Permutation and combination probability. Two questions from the PNC and two questions from the probability came last year, means four questions are there. You can keep into the algebra part or you can keep into the miscellaneous portion. Quadratic is very good chapter. Is the major beauty of this chapter is that there is no too much concept you have to gone through. If you have done the quadratic equation properly, then certainly quadratic and sequence and series, this question you have solved, you can solve easily. Because sequence and series, in general, they are asking either the special series or they are asking the question on AMGM inequality. So if you focus on these two particular area, then certainly you will attempt these two questions, means sequence and series particularly. Trigonometry comprises with the three questions, one from the ratio, one from the inverse trigonometry, and third question from the solution of triangle. Solution of triangle in general not coming on regular basis, but last year it came. Now I am coming on the other portion, vector and 3D. This is another bread and butter, means bonus marks, you can say whatever, because the four questions are matters a lot for the final examination. Two questions from the vector, or you can say two questions from the 3D. Some students leave this portion because they think the 3D is very, very tough. But here as a math teacher, I would like to keep your belief on this chapter. The vector and 3D really easy chapter. If you do the input, if you give the input for the calculus part only, suppose it is in terms of work, if I say x, then by using x by 2, certainly you can achieve vector and 3D question marks successfully. And the percentage of this portion is 11.29 in the last year. So if I summarize this whole discussion, so I would like to say, first of all, you must focus on the calculus part, because 5 + 6 = 11 questions are there. After this, PNC and probability 2 + 2 = 4 questions are there. Vector and 3D 4 questions are there. And remaining is in your hand, what you want to do. But before doing any experiment, my advice to all, please pick the question properly. And after that, you must start the paper. Before making any planning, please don't start the paper. Here, I would like to share the same things in the Hindi also, so that the audience which come from the North India, they can also understand what I want to say. मेरा कहना यहाँ पर ये होगा कि आप कैलकुलस पे सबसे पहले जाइए. कैलकुलस पे पहले जाइए. If possible, please mute your mic. Those who have keep. First of all, coordinate geometry is there. Coordinate geometry 5 questions. So in priority order. In priority order, मैं सबको कहना चाहूँगा पहले कैलकुलस के इन 11 या 10 क्वेश्चन को अपनी पकड़ में लाने की कोशिश करें. इन 10 में से अगर आप 6 से 7 क्वेश्चन भी लेके आते हैं, तो आपके दोनों पेपर में 3-3, 4-4 क्वेश्चन आपसे बनेंगे. कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री में 5 क्वेश्चन हैं, उनको आप अच्छी तरीके से कर सकते हैं, प्रोवाइडेड कि आप इस इंप्रेशन में ना जाएं कि स्ट्रेट लाइन का क्वेश्चन स्ट्रेट लाइन से होगा या सर्किल का क्वेश्चन सर्किल से ही होगा. स्ट्रेट लाइन के क्वेश्चन में बिना सर्किल के क्वेश्चन कंप्लीट नहीं होगा. और अगर टेंजेंट बेस्ड क्वेश्चन है जो इन जनरल पूछा जा रहा है, उसमें आपको सर्किल और एलिप्स या एलिप्स एंड हाइपरबोला में कहीं ना कहीं कॉम्बिनेशन बनाना होगा. दे आर नॉट आस्किंग पर्टिकुलरली फ्रॉम एनी पर्टिकुलर चैप्टर. जेई मेंस में ऐसा हो सकता है कि आपको सिंगल कॉन्सेप्ट का क्वेश्चन मिल जाए. एडवांस में ऐसा ढूंढने की कोशिश मत कीजिएगा. हम लोग जो लगातार टेस्ट सीरीज कर रहे हैं, हम लोगों का ग्रांड टेस्ट सीरीज जो लगातार चल रही है, उस सभी ग्रांड टेस्ट के अंदर हम लोगों का बेस्ट एफर्ट होता है कि क्वेश्चन को हम इंटीग्रेट करें इन सच अ वे कि वो क्वेश्चन 360 डिग्री पर पूरे सब्जेक्ट को कवर करें. और उस सब्जेक्ट की कवरेज करते वक्त हम ये ध्यान रखते हैं कि वो क्वेश्चन कहीं ना कहीं बाउंड्री क्रॉस ना कर जाए, मींस कि वो आईआईटी के लिए इररिलेवेंट ना हो जाए. ये वर्ड मैंने इसलिए ऐड किया क्योंकि कुछ बच्चे ये मान के चलते हैं. मैडम योर माइक इज म्यूट, प्लीज कीप योर म्यूट. कुछ स्टूडेंट ये मान के चलते हैं कि जो क्वेश्चन आएगा, मेरा डिस्कशन ये था कि हाइब्रिड क्वेश्चन की तरफ मैं फिर से लेके आता हूँ उस बात को. हाइब्रिड क्वेश्चन को करने से पहले अपने दिमाग में कॉन्सेप्ट को गैदर करें और उसके बाद ही क्वेश्चन को अटेम्प्ट करें. मेंस जैसा माइंडसेट वहाँ पे काम नहीं करता. हम लोग जो रेगुलर प्रैक्टिस अपने स्टूडेंट के साथ कर रहे हैं, मे भी यहाँ पे नारायणा के हम लोग के ग्रुप के भी कुछ स्टूडेंट हों, उनसे मेरा ये समीशन होगा, कुछ भी नया मत करिए. इंटरनेट पर नया प्रॉब्लम ढूंढने से कुछ नया नहीं मिलेगा. जो करेंगे या आप ढूंढने की जो कोशिश करेंगे, उससे सर्टेनली आप ट्रैप हो जाएंगे, आपका टाइम किल होगा. एंड दिस इज द हाई टाइम टू सेव योर टाइम. आपको अपने आप को उस जगह पे फोकस करना है जहां से आउटपुट आए. क्योंकि अगर आप करना स्टार्ट करें कि स्ट्रेट लाइन में पूरी खत्म करूंगा, तो ऐसी कोई सब्जेक्ट नहीं है जो कभी चैप्टर खत्म होगा. आपको नया प्रॉब्लम ढूंढने की बजाय, जैसा अनुराग सर ने भी शेयर किया, संजीव सर ने शेयर किया, कि आप वो काम करिए जो आप कर चुके हैं, कुछ नया मत करिए. ट्राई टू कवर ऑल दोज कॉन्सेप्ट दैट यू हैव डन अर्लियर. जस्ट ट्राई टू कंप्लीट एंड ट्राई टू कंसोलिडेट द ऑल दोज कॉन्सेप्ट विच यू हैव डन अर्लियर. अपार्ट फ्रॉम इट, यू हैव टू डू ओनली वन थिंग. जहां भी आप ज्वाइंट हैं, वेदर यू आर इन एक्स वाई जेड एनी इंस्टीट्यूट, उस सभी इंस्टीट्यूट्स के पुराने पेपर्स आपके पास होंगे. उन पेपर में आपने कब कहाँ क्या गलती की थी, अगर आपके पास उसका एनालिसिस है, तो आप उसको कोशिश करिए कि उस एनालिसिस के थ्रू आप अपनी मिस्टेक्स को ओवरकम करें. इफ योर मिस्टेक विल ओवरकम, देन डेफिनेटली योर मार्क्स विल इम्प्रूव. सो दिस वॉज माई डिस्कशन अबाउट द मैथ्स. एंड हियर आई हैव बीन एम्फेसाइज्ड पर्टिकुलरली ऑन कैलकुलस, सेकेंड एल्जेब्रा, थर्ड कोऑर्डिनेट एंड फोर्थ एंड फिफ्थ. इट विल डिपेंड्स ऑन द टाइम. इन द एग्जामिनेशन, आप क्या उस समय पर किस सिचुएशन में, मतलब अपने आप को किन किन क्वेश्चंस के साथ आप कवर कर चुके हैं। ऐसा बिल्कुल नहीं है कि आप हर पोर्शन को टच कर पाएंगे, और ऐसा करने की जरूरत भी नहीं होती है। जस्ट यू फोकस ऑन योर स्ट्रेंथ एंड एरिया, आपने क्या अच्छा किया था आपको वो पहचान हो जाएगी। आपको क्या नहीं आता या आप ये ऐसा कर लेंगे, ऐसा एक्सपेरिमेंट मत करिए। दिस इज द ओनली सिंसियर रिक्वेस्ट विथ ऑल डियर स्टूडेंट्स। नाउ आई एम कमिंग ऑन ओवरऑल मास डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ जेई एडवांस 2019 में क्लास 11th और क्लास 12th। हेयर आई एम शेयरिंग द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ क्लास 11th एंड क्लास 12th मार्क्स। मीन्स टोटल पेपर वॉज ऑफ 372 मार्क्स, टू पेपर वॉज देयर 186 ईच। इन 186, 62 मार्क्स फॉर फिजिक्स, 62 मार्क्स फॉर केमिस्ट्री एंड मैथ्स एज वेल। मीन्स 62 × 3 186, 186 × 2 372। सभी लोग इस पैटर्न को अच्छी तरह जानते हैं। आईआईटी में तीनों सब्जेक्ट आते हैं तीनों पेपर में। आइडियली तीनों पेपर के लिए, दोनों पेपर के लिए आपको 3 आवर्स टाइम दिया जाता है। इन दिस 3 आवर्स यू हैव टू सॉल्व फिजिक्स, केमिस्ट्री एंड मैथ्स, बट इट डजंट मीन्स यू हैव टू डिवोट 1 आवर फॉर केमिस्ट्री और 1 आवर फॉर फिजिक्स एंड मैथ्स इन दिस यूनिटरी मैथड। यू हैव टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट योर टाइम आफ्टर एनालाइजिंग द पेपर। आपको उस दिन उस सब्जेक्ट में उस पर्टिकुलर पेपर में आपको अपना स्ट्रेंथ पहचानना है। अगर आपको ये पहचान है कि मेरी स्ट्रेंथ किधर है, अकॉर्डिंगली यू मस्ट टारगेट। नाउ हेयर आई एम शेयरिंग द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ द क्लास 11th एंड क्लास 12th कॉम्पोनेंट कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन इन योर फाइनल एग्जामिनेशन। फ्रॉम द क्लास 11th द टोटल कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑल टूगेदर केमिस्ट्री मैथ्स एंड फिजिक्स वॉज 146 out of 372। इट इज अप्रॉक्सीमेट 40% and 226 marks from the class 12th syllabus. As Sanjeev sir said, as Anurag sir also said, as far as maths is concerned, I already told 40 to 45% 40 to 45% syllabus will come from the class 11 and 55 to 60% will come from the 12th portion. Here I would like to share two different analyses. One is the class-wise marks, means in chemistry, the 38 marks question came from the class 11 and 86 marks paper set from the class 12th syllabus. As far as maths is concerned, the 47 marks ka class 11th ka aapse pucha gaya tha, aapse means aapke senior batch se pucha gaya tha. 77 from the class 12th, vice versa 61 and 63 into the physics. If I come on to the class-wise number of questions, the 11 questions of chemistry from the class 11th, 14 questions in maths and 18 questions in physics from the class 11th only, means total number of questions was 54 in each subject. In the next slide, I would like to share the difficulty level analysis. This is the very very good analysis for you at this time. आप लोगों को ये जानना बहुत जरूरी है कि इस पेपर के अंदर जैसा आईआईटी में कहा जाता है, सोचा जाता है, as Anurag sir said, very very good example about the Dara Singh, कि Dara Singh को देख के ही Dara Singh का चोर भाग गया। Similarly, आईआईटी को अंदर जाने से पहले most of the student feel कि मुझसे आईआईटी नहीं होगा, and in this impression they are not able to recognize the question, which one is easy or which one is tough. Question करने से पहले question का mindset मत बनाइए, question देखने के बाद mindset बनाइए कि आप उस paper में उस दिन क्या करेंगे। अगर आप JEE Advanced 2019 के analysis को देखें, so 64 marks you can score from the easy section only, 172 comes from the medium category, means obviously some effort is required. Medium level means it is the of advanced level. I would not like to say this is very very easy. Medium means it is not like JEE mains level, but obviously 172 plus 64 it is in your reach. Practically I am speaking, 136 marks work you can do if you have the time. आपके पास time है तो आप 136 पे experiment करिए, otherwise 172 plus 64 इट मींस नियरली 200-225 के आसपास आप आ जाते हैं एंड इट इज वेरी वेरी गुड मार्क्स फॉर एडवांस्ड कैटेगरी मींस आई एम नॉट सेइंग यू शुड नॉट अटेम्प्ट द डिफिकल्ट लेवल बट माय सबमिशन इज हियर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू मस्ट ट्राई विद द इजी लेवल आफ्टर दैट यू शुड गो फॉर द मीडियम लेवल एंड if not possible or possible as per on that day particular strategy difficult level it depends on your strategy on your means time what is the time in your hand then you can attempt with this is the question wise difficulty analysis here again in blue strip there is easy questions means 9 questions here from the chemistry 21 questions belongs to medium category and 6 questions that I said earlier it is tough or maybe very very tough there is no line of demarcation as such so that I can say the question is tough or question is very very tough it depends on the understanding of the question sometimes or for some students it may be tough or for some student it may be very very tough so please see this slide particularly if needed you can take the screenshot also because if these two categories you cover carefully then 100% I can assure you you have reached at your target now you are very very close as far as your desirous ambition you can reach by these marks only and these two categories you can cover by using the subject weightage analysis as physics Anurag sir and chemistry Sandeep sir told you already Here some rank versus marks percentage analysis. Here I would like to request Anurag sir. Anurag sir.
Yes.
Sir, please. This is the rank versus marks percentage analysis. I will request to you. Please explain this thing to our dearest students.
Okay. Actually, this is the rank versus marks analysis for nearly 10 years. But overall, if you will say. See that to get a rank in top 10 in general every year to get a rank in top 10 you must score between 80-90% approximately for plus minus 2-3% up down ho sakta hai but it is a broad range which you will find every for the complete 10 years 80-90% marks scorer is always in top 10 then to get a rank in top 100 your score must be above 70% marks in general except you will find that 2016 when the paper was very tough you can see the 2016 there 2016 yes there the 500 rank you can get in 54% marks and within 100 rank was in 2016 the within jo top 100 mein rank thi 65% marks scorer was in top 100 63% marks that was exceptional year but except the 2016 you will find that anybody who is scoring 60% marks will be in approximately 500-700 rank and those who are scoring more than 55% marks they will be in top 1000 and top 50% marks you will be in top 2000 so that means to get a rank in top 2000 your score must be more than 50% to get a rank in top 1000 you must be more than 55-60% to get a rank in top 500 your score must be nearly 60-65% and to get a rank in top 100 you should score more than 70-75% and to top 10 it should be an 80-90% it is always every year you will find that means one thing is also clear that except one or two year they have maintained a consistency of exam also and also you will find the last student who has got rank nearly you can say 10,000 rank his score is nearly 38-40% 40% marks you can say that means a student who is getting 40% marks will get a seat in IITJ you can see every year you will find that 5,000 rank is around 49-50% around aa jata because after that you will find after 2000 the marks almost within 5-10% marks nearly 3000 ranks are there so you will find that ki 2000 tak to 550% marks chahiye lekin 5000 तक भी लगभग 45% मार्क्स में 5000 रैंक भी आपकी आ जाएगी। तो ये कहने का मतलब यही है कि आपको वहां पर ज्यादा स्ट्रगल होता, वहां एक मार्क्स की भी गलती, और यही इस एग्जाम की पेकुलरिटी। जब कहते हैं कि एक यहाँ पर जितना इम्पोर्टेंट है कि हाउ टू सेलेक्ट टू द क्वेश्चन टू अटेम्प्ट, यू मस्ट बी गुड इनफ टू सेलेक्ट अ क्वेश्चन टू लीव। इस एग्जाम की पेकुलरिटी ये है कि इसमें ये सेलेक्ट करने में आपकी खासियत नहीं होनी चाहिए कि मैं कौन कौन से, क्योंकि सारे क्वेश्चन तो आपसे वैसे भी नहीं होने, तो कौन से क्वेश्चन मुझे छोड़ने हैं और कौन से मुझसे नहीं होंगे, ये अगर आप डिसीजन ले पाते हैं एग्जाम में, तो एक तो निगेटिव मार्किंग बचेगी, और सेकेंड थिंग द टाइम विच यू विल सेव विल बी यूजफुल फॉर दोज क्वेश्चन विच यू कैन अटेम्प्ट राइट। सो वेन एवर इन दीज 1.5 months यू रिवाइज, यू ऑलवेज सी दैट your selection in leaving question is equally good as selecting a question to attempt. That is very important. And almost every year the range is almost same. So this is the thing. And top 10,000 and the girls numbers what Pawan sir was showing has increased because there is a reservation now for girls also in IITs. That is why the girls number has been shown separately, 5,000 something which you were showing earlier. And second thing, जो paper toughness की बात पवन सर कह रहे थे, in general you can remember that 10% question will be of easy category, 40% question will be of mediocre category, and 50% question will be of tough category. ये plus minus 5-10% हो सकता है, उस 50% में 25% tough होता है, at 25% very tough होता है. तो जो easy question, mediocre question और tough question को कर लेता है, that student can score 75% marks and he can get a rank in top 100. To get a rank in top 10, he must score at least 50% of the very tough question. That means, jo 25% bilkul tough hai, bahut tough hai, unke agar aap 12.5 number bhi laate hai, to 75 plus 12.5, that makes it 87.5. And 87.5 makes you a ranker of first, second, third ranker. So that means, jo bahut tough exam, isiliye paper ki peculiarity ye hai, कि वो 10% अगर 10 बच्चों को छोड़ दें तो इन जनरल ये पेपर 80% से ज्यादा 75% ज्यादा कोई अटेम्प्ट नहीं कर पाता। तो सारा टारगेट उसी पे रखिए। इफ यू आर वेरी एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरी यू विल 100% डू ऑल द थिंग्स, बट नॉर्मली ट्राई टू अटेम्प्ट द क्वेश्चन 70-75%, यू विल गेट अ रैंक इन टॉप 100। 70-75% में आपको 30% क्वेश्चन छोड़ने को मिल रहा है, और ये आपका डिसीजन कि मैं कौन से 30% क्वेश्चन छोड़ूंगा, that will be the deciding factor for your rank, because that time will be saved, aapki negative marking bachegi, aur wo time aap un questions ko doge jo aapse actually ho sakte hain, so that will improve your performance. This is now Pawan sir, you can take over.
Okay sir, thank you sir. This is just an illustration of the number of students qualified for the JEE Advance from 2013 to 2018, and major discussion about the 2019 we have already done. This is the 2013-14-15, approximate 1.5 lakh students was there, and the last to last year it was 2,24,000 as like as previous. At the end of the discussion almost, because advanced part we have been discussed in detail, and after the at the end of the session we will come on to the Q&A session. So those who have the doubt, they can ask the question on a particular subject or particular query. If you have, you can share it here. At the end of the session, just I would like to share chapter-wise weightage of maths in JEE Mains, because still one attempt has been left. So whatever the mistake committed by your side in the January attempt, now you can make over it into the next 1st September to 6th September. The date has been released by NTA. Under this panic situation, they have taken, and it is very, very appreciable welcome from our side, so that our last year student, those who have stuck into the last session and they are feeling the pressure right now, I would like to thanks to NTA department also for this. So this is the mathematics chapter wise weightage in JEE Mains. These are the major category. Here I have been illustrated each and everything in pie chart. This is a screenshot. All the students can take the screenshot. I would like to put focus on those areas which is in general skill. Sets and relation, one question they are asking regularly, but the mindset of the student, they are more engaged with the calculus or algebra. Here I am talking about mains. Sets and relation is not of advanced topic. One question they are asking regularly, reasoning it not in advance, still they are asking one question regularly in each and every session out of the 4 or 5 days from the reasoning itself. Height and distance, these are 3 to 4 questions, and statistics also. Apart from it, remaining all topics belongs to the JEE Advanced also. So whatever you have been prepared for the JEE Advanced, that will be useful for JEE Mains. But for the JEE Mains to get 3 to 4 solution, 3 to 4 keys, or 3 to 4 marks, you can say, means for that you have to focus on these 3 or 4 questions, and by giving little input you can get more here. But for that you have to become more specific. And similarly, the chapter wise weightage of physics in JEE Mains, so if any suggestion from the Anurag sir side, please share some inputs for the chapter wise weightage of physics, where the student should put focus apart from advanced.
The weightage for advanced as well as mains, the in physics it is almost same. So they must always emphasize on heat and thermodynamics, modern physics. And in this case, as far as JEE Mains is concerned, there is one topic, diffraction and polarization, which is not in advance. There is one topic, semiconductors, which is not in advance. Such topics, as far as this semiconductors is concerned, you solve the questions of NCERT exampler. Because many times they take question directly from the exampler, go through the NCERT book. As far as the semiconductors is concerned, electromagnetic waves is concerned, direct questions from NCERT book or exemplar are asked in that portion, and that can fetch you easy marks. Remaining, the weightage, what I told, ki you should always focus on heat and thermodynamics, modern physics, or geometrical optics, wave optics, sound and wave, fluids and properties of matter. This 50% paper is always very easy. And electromagnetism is 100%. Usme se jo 30-35% question aata, 50% is easily solvable. So all these things, what was true for advanced is true for mains also.
Yes, similarly, some analysis from the Sandeep sir also for chemistry. Sandeep sir, please share your analysis.
Thank you, sir. As we have discussed earlier, winning a war is important, not every battle. So in chemistry, there are so many chapters, and we simply classify under 3 different things. So we can't say that we just should go only for this section or that section. The only one advice is don't go for negative marking. Normally, students realize that he knows each and everything of chemistry. In mathematics, they realize they don't know the question. But in chemistry, they are aware of every question. They know the answer of every question. That's another thing that later on they realize they did a mistake. So only attempt those questions for which you are very sure, and be focused on 12th syllabus more and more if you are not very much confident in that very topic. Because in the last trend of last so many years, we have realized around 40% questions are there from class 11th and 60% from class 12 on an average. So class 12 should be in a very, syllabus of class 12 should be very, very well done by you. And there are some of the topics from which we get quite frequent number of questions, like biomolecules and some other aspects of environmental chemistry. And particularly for mains, if we talk about mains, as covering the NCERT book syllabus is good enough for mains. For advanced, surely it will sort for. But for mains, if you are confident on the content of NCERT book, that will fairly good, will give you a good marks in that. And there are a few chapters in which you should go through carefully, like in metallurgy. For mains, every detail, whatever is written in NCERT book, that is meant for you. But for advanced, all industrial details are excluded. So that portion should be taken care with due caution. Industrial details are not there in advance, but here it is meant for mains. To some extent, to the extent it is given in the book, and rest of the things are you learned person have already shared with them. So go for your instinct. Go on, sir.
Thank you, sir. And this is a last but not least, JE Mains cutoff trend analysis. After that, we will share some features of NDigital, and ma'am will share, Manisha ma'am will share what we can do and what we are doing with our existing student and what we are planning for the further due course, means remaining 1 and 2 months. As far as JE Mains 2019 cutoff analysis, the general cutoff was 89. This is the category wise. For general, it was 89. For OBC, it was 74. And similarly, 54 and 44 for SC and ST category. In general, if I put all the fruits in single basket, then I can say the 100 marks is the sufficient to get the clear the cutoff. But our target should not only to cut off. It is just I put into the last of the discussion, means just by getting these marks, the student will be eligible to write the advanced examination. And here I would like to request Manisha ma'am, please summarize the things. And if the students have any doubt, then please take him, and then we will discuss with the students.
Thank you, Pavan sir, Anurag sir, and Sanjeev sir, for your valuable information. This is an interactive session. I would request the participants attending the webinar can ask some valid questions from our distinguished guests. So I'll name one by one. Please raise your hands if we have any questions.
And the participants have already posted some questions in the Q&A. So you can have a look at that, and the professor can answer the questions accordingly.
Yes, sir, we can do that, sir. We can just note the answers, the questions also, and just ask you. There's a child called Anonymous, sir. He wants to ask something, sir. Anonymous?
Yeah, one question is there. And let me respond over it. One student has been asked, what should be the test frequency per week and paper analysis methodology? Most of the student, it is not the doubt for single student. 100% this is the doubt of each and every one, means what should be the paper analysis methodology. After doing the paper, still they are unable to know what they did and what they have to do. So here I would like to say, in our system, what we are doing, particularly I'm talking about our system, and if you have already doing this thing, then 100% this is the right path that as you are doing. After the examination, we are giving the 13 slides. We are taking, we are putting R&D analysis on the particular subject wise, paper wise analysis, marks wise analysis. We have total 13 slides for each and every paper. Here we are discussing and here we are observing where the student is lagging. How many questions across nationwide the student has not done properly? What is the problem in that particular area? And on that particular area, we are releasing our video on a specific concept. Suppose in vector 3D, some student or maximum student has been done that question wrongly. Then after observing that analysis, we are putting, we are sharing, we are releasing our video. Our experts are sharing some questions. Our experts are sharing some tips so that a student can think that question in the next time whenever they will face, 100% that analysis will be helpful for them. So my advice with all of the student, after doing the examination, don't put the paper into the dustbin. The paper, after doing the paper, it is really that work that you have devoted for that particular work, you have devoted 3 hours or 6 hours. So after devoting this lot of time, you must go through by the analysis. You must see wherever you have done the mistake, because without knowing the mistake, if you are attending the next paper again, it means from the previous paper, you have not learned anything. And it is a gradual process. It has to be done in the regular manner. In our system, in each and every paper, for each and every paper, we are providing the sample question. We are providing the similar type of problem where the question, where the student commits the error. Same type of questions the faculties are doing for the, giving for the practice, so that student become familiar with that concept wherever they have done wrong mistake or whatever the doubt, they can share. They can, after sharing or they can see our videos, they can attempt our paper by which they will become strengthened.
Thank you so much.
And this is another question. I am just one question I am handling, ma'am. One more question is there.
Yes, sir.
Both
yes,
students sir. Are asking.
Yes, sir.
Test frequency per week. What should be the test frequency per week? It depends on their institute. It depends on their self-study program, whether they have taken the online test series, whether they are joined with some institute in a particular manner. So whatever the institutes is giving the instruction to them, they must follow without any deviation, because this is not the time to do experiment. As I said earlier, whatever the instructions are coming from your institute, from your faculty, and you must follow religiously. And after the paper analysis, you must clear those doubts with your concerned faculty. Thank you, ma'am. So you can start with the next question now.
Thank you so much, sir. I thank all our distinguished guests. I thank all the guests who have attended the such an informative webinar. Those who have already joined Narayana group and are studying through our Narayana live online classes are welcome to be a part of Narayana family. And those who are still left out must take decision at the earliest. As you know, time does not wait for anyone. I would just like to share every bit of information. Those who have attended the webinar, we have an orientation class. We can write it down also. We have an orientation class to interact with the India's top faculty. This is physics on 6th August, that is Thursday, 4 p.m. to 5 p.m. Mathematics, August 7th, Friday, 4 p.m. to 5 p.m. I would repeat again, we have an orientation class for our 12th pass JE students, physics, 6th August, Thursday, 4 to 5 p.m. Mathematics, 7th Friday, 4 to 5 p.m. Students can register themselves to move to our site at bit.ly.nje40. So we'll just share the things with you at the end of the webinar. Also, once again, I thank to all of you to attend this webinar and clear your doubts. I welcome you all to think about your career and join the success team of Narayana Group. For any further information or query, please call us on our number given in the screen. Please feel free to give your valuable suggestions and feedback about this seminar. I thank everyone who have joined this webinar and given your valuable time. Thank you, sir. I'm just sharing the numbers where you can coordinate with us for further classes, as well as put in your valuable feedback on this about this seminar.
Avansa, if you could,
Mr. Shashank, if anyone is there or who is raising the hand.
Yes, yes, sir. Yes, sir. One participant is raising his hand, sir.
Yeah, Aditya Jaiswal raised the hand. Aditya, please share your concern. Mr. Shashank, please give him the permission to speak over the conference.
Just yes, one second.
Aditya Jaiswal is there.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Aditya, kindly go ahead.
Hello, good evening, sir.
Good evening, Aditya. Good evening. Please share your concern.
Sir, the main concern was that, the test series, which test series should I join?
Obvious, Narayana.
Okay, therefore I do not have to look at any other test. This was in the Narayana test series. The question comes from module only. The module with all.
No, Aditya, I would like to interrupt here.
Yes, sir.
The mains type of questions or the questions, regular question paper, maybe you have seen the question from the module only, but the this time we are conducting online grand test series. We are conducting the advanced paper series exclusively. So wherever you want to, whatever your interest, accordingly you take the inputs from the front house of executive after the session, after this conference, you can dial us. And after that, you will come to know there are two types of test series. One is for mains and other for is advanced.
Okay. But I had joined only one test series.
You should take only one. And in one only, we will cover both the things. If you cover, if you take the mains product, then 100% advanced test series will also there. From which city you are talking, Aditya? Where are you, Aditya? Okay, Mr. Shashank, is anyone is here?
Hello, is anyone there to ask the question? It's an interactive session.
No. Hello. Nobody else is raising their hand.
Yes, we have one, sir. Sai Haran Kumar Reddy. We have one student.
Hello, sir.
Yes, Sai, you wanted to say something?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, you can just raise your question.
Can we prepare the chemistry new chapters for in this period, ma'am? Which I feel difficult is.
Could you just repeat your question again?
Can we prepare for new chapters in this period, ma'am?
Can we prepare the chemistry new chapters for in this period, ma'am?
Well, I suppose this question has already been answered by Anurag sir, and that he has rightly said at this juncture there is no point of his beginning any chapter. You just try to concentrate the chapter, whatever is known to you, just try to build up some more concept over there. Starting a new chapter is not at all advisable.
Sai, I will respond to you. As we have discussed that this exam is a low scoring exam, even 35% scorer or 40% scorer can qualify. So if you have not prepared 20-25% of the chapters, don't worry about them. Just concentrate on the chapters. If you have prepared 60% of the syllabus, strengthen it at this juncture. So even if you are able to score, suppose you have prepared for 60% of the portion and you are able to correct 45% of the paper at that time, you are in the list. So don't worry, because if you will start new things, you will lose your confidence, and the things in which you are comfortable, that will also go down.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Hello, are there any other participants? Do I close the webinar? I would just request the participants to just take down, if you are available there, just take down the numbers. This is our toll-free number. You can call us on this number to take any information. It's 1-800-102-3344. Again, I'll repeat, it's 1-800-102-3344. Also, you can visit our website. It's info@narayanagroup.com. You can
Hello,
email,
good evening, sir.
Yeah, you can email your queries out here to us.
Hello, good evening, sir. Is it for advance? Is it suggested to do level 5 and level 6 of Narayana module now? I have 1 month only left.
There's another question. So there's another question from one student, Sir Vivek. So we have a student called Vivek, sir.
Well, Vivek, if you are just preparing, you have done that very chapter earlier. Now you are practicing the question, then it's fine. You can do, if you are confident enough, only then go ahead to level 5 and 6. Because level 5 and 6 are meant for advanced level. So if you are having sufficient basic idea of that mini chapter, then go ahead. Otherwise, you don't.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir. So could we, sir, I think we've already imparted all the information, valuable information to our participants. And now we'll just close this seminar, this webinar. And any queries, they can put it on the email as well as call us on the toll-free number. Thank you to all of you. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
We'll just close this seminar, this webinar. And any queries, they can put it. Thank you so much.